first thing you just have to touch. That one thing you must lay your hands on. I believe we have the same answer. Our mobile phones.
Oh. Oh, okay. Yes. Yes, I get it.
You may smile or laugh, but it is a real condition. You may smile or laugh, but it's a real condition. Let's do a simple test. Can anyone in this room announce to the world, I can live without my phone? No, right? It's a condition people tend to overlook. So in my speech, I will highlight two signs of nomophobia and a possible scenario on both of them. Firstly, feelings of anxiousness over a missing phone. It begins with anxiety. You feel anxious from head to toe. Followed by it begins with anxiety from head to toe, followed by anxiousness. Followed by anxiousness. And the next thing you know, it's the end of the world. Here's a possible scenario. Your hand, you touch your pocket, and it's not there. You find yourself out running to your room, turning everything upside down, topsy-turvy over a single phone. And just before you accuse anyone of snatching your phone, you finally found it. It's been playing hide-and-seek with you, hiding under a pillow. Relief finally floods in. You finally remember to breathe. And if you think that's messed up, wait till you hear about the other sign of nomophobia. Secondly, compulsively checking your phone for notifications. People who love their phones a little bit too much will develop an unhealthy attachment towards their phone. Here's another possible scenario. You find your hands twitching continuously, and you stare at your phone. Did he text me? Did Renika reply my WhatsApp message? And worst come to worst, you may ask yourself, did anyone like my Instagram selfie? It can get worse up to the point that the number of likes on social media is tied to your self-esteem or self-worth. Checking your phone for updates becomes from a want to a need. fellow Toastmasters, guests, and fellow nomophobics. To recap, number one, feelings of anxiousness over a missing phone. Number two, compulsively checking in your phone for updates. There is absolutely nothing wrong with having a phone. It's just a matter of not letting it go too far until you get addicted to your phone. So before I end my speech, I leave all of you with a tip. Switch off your phone whenever you're with your loved ones. Or in our case, when we all go to supper later, remember to switch off your phone so you can interact with one another properly. Don't let technology control you. You control it. Thank you. Back to you.